air pressure. When I blow this balloon, I am putting a lot of air inside. Air has lots of molecules. These molecules are moving randomly inside balloon. These molecules hit the wall of the balloon continuously and exert a force on the wall. Thus, pressure is created inside the balloon. When I release the air, it can move this toy car forward. Let me take these two balloons and place it on the balance.
Their weight is same.
Now let me inflate one balloon and repeat the activity. What will happen? Will it be the same as before?
This time we see that balloon filled with air is having some weight.
The balance is tilted towards it. Air is a mixture of gases like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, and many more. All these gases have some mass, and mass of air is the combined mass of all the gases it contains. Since air has mass, it has weight. We just saw that air has mass. It exerts some force on us. On the earth, air exerts force all over. On any given area, it is equal to the weight of all the air in the atmosphere above it. If I put this newspaper on the table, the air above it is pushing it downward. Let me slide this wooden plank under the paper. What will happen if I hit hard on the other side? Will the newspaper rise above the table? Let's try it. When I hit the wooden plank hard, wood plank under the newspaper could not move. This was due to all the pressure exerted by the air above it. This enabled me to break the wooden plank. For it to work, I had to try a wooden plank of different sizes. Wooden plank of 1 inch or small width did not break. Planks with small width flew off like this. Try it with different sizes of wood as well as plywood. Now we know that air exerts pressure. As we go higher and higher in the sky, air becomes thinner and thinner. Less air, less pressure as we move away from Earth. Air pressure at sea level is called atmospheric pressure. Air pressure is measured in bar. 1 bar is equal to 100,000 pascals. If air pressure is that high, why can't we feel it? It is because it is applied from all sides on our body. Net effect of it is zero. We don't feel it. What happens when pressure inside container is less than outside? Air from outside pushes hard on the container. Let me pour hot boiling water in the plastic container and empty it immediately. Can you guess what happens to air inside? Air also becomes hot and some air escapes from the container. As I immediately close the lid, there is now less air inside. The pressure inside the bottle is now lower than the pressure outside the bottle. As time passes, bottle starts to crumble as outside air is pushing it from all sides. What will happen if I pour ice cold water on the top of this crumbled bottle? Try it yourself and analyze the result. We will take this plastic tube and place it inside this bottle. Bottle has some colored water. This will enable clear viewing of the label. I have another plastic tube which is connected here. When I blow through the open end, liquid water rises up on the other side. If I attach a balloon to this end, I can measure pressure inside it. Let's give it a try. I inflate a balloon and attach it to the tube. Level of water starts rising. Why blue water in other tube rises? Air from the balloon pushes the air inside the bottle. This air inside bottle then pushes the water. What will happen if I prick the balloon with a small hole? As air escapes, the pressure inside the balloon reduces. This also brings the level of water in the tube down. When all the air has escaped, blue water is back to its normal level. Instead of one balloon, if I put another balloon inside this one and then inflate it, what will be pressure now? Will it be more or less when only one balloon was used? Give it a try.
Summary.
We discussed the concept of pressure. We looked at its behavior in gases. Since air has mass, it has weight. Air pressure at sea level is called atmospheric pressure. Air pressure is measured in bar. Try these activities yourself to understand pressure in a better way.